video that you're watching right now will be in the control panel area, so you'll be able to reference it at all times. And also anybody else that will be into the system will be able to see it. You pretty much have the same kind of control panel as you did in the previous version. You're adding an article, the article manager, front page manager, media manager, menu manager, user manager. These are the areas that you'll be. Typically, you'll mainly be in the article manager. That's where all the pages of the website are located as well. And then I'm going to be showing you in the components how to do the JCal Pro. So first, we'll take a look at the article manager. We'll click on that, and that's going to list all the different articles that there are on the website. Just go down here and go ahead and display all of them. Same as before, you'll be able to get into each one of them. And it'll look pretty much the same. Oop, I'm going to fix that. Actually, that background is very hard for you to read this, so I will get that changed. But as you can see, there's writing in there right now. So you'll be able to type in it just like you always were before with the What You See Is What You Get editor. And you can click on image the same as you did before, and it will pull up your media manager just like it did in the last one. It's just a little bit more, it's just a cleaner look. The parameters over here, this is a little bit different. These are the article parameters, the advanced parameters. What I do is I hide the author, create a date, modified date. You don't have to, you can show them, but all these different things you can hide if you like. And then meta information, you can add this sort of information. This helps in search engines, so that's definitely up to you. Then you would hit save, and that's how you edit one of the pages that are already there. And just like before, if you want to add something new, you just click on the new button. Now, in regards to menu items, your main menu, if you go to menus and then main menu, you'll see all your menu items that are listed here. So if you ever need to unpublish something, you can do that by just clicking on one of these little check boxes or check marks, and it'll make it into a circle with an X. So that's pretty simple. Now we'll go up to, let's look at the media manager. You can put all your images into the stories folder. That's where it all defaults to. So you want to make sure you put things in there. PDFs, you can load PDFs in there, not through this, so I'll show you a different way to do that. When you're in the article manager and you have a PDF that you want to load up, let's go back into music theater. And let's say I want to add a PDF to that. What I would do is I would click or highlight what you want to be connected to the PDF, and I would click on this insert edit link. I'm sorry, I think that's wrong. I think what you want to do, insert edit image. Yes, insert edit image. And then go down here to PDF. That opened up, and then what you do is you want to search for it on your hard drive. So you click on add, and then you find the PDF, and you would hit open, which would then pull it in here, and you'd hit upload. Once it uploaded, it would show it right there, and then you would just highlight it or click on it. And then it would automatically put the information up here. You can give it an alternative text title. And then you would hit insert. And it would create a link to that PDF. And it would have automatically put that PDF in that media folder. But that's the easiest way to do the PDFs. Is again, by highlighting, clicking on image, click on PDF folder, search, and add. for you in terms of the gallery. So go ahead and work on those particular